Hello, my name is Marek Pollet. Welcome to the next part of the Grenton Academy. Today I will talk about the Gate HTTP integration module. The HTTP protocol that we use in the Gate module is an information exchange protocol used, among others, by web browsers. In the previous parts of the Grenton Academy, I talked about the modules responsible for controlling the basic functions in the house, like lighting, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, or blinds. The Gate HTTP module is an integration module that is our system's window to the world. It is a device that connects us with the other devices from the IoT world. Through this module, we can connect the Grenton system to a number of other devices, which you may buy or add to your home in the future. It can be, for example, a smart TV, household appliances, audio-video equipment, multimedia speakers, automatically operating lawnmowers or vacuum cleaners, as well as a number of internet services that will provide you data to your home in the future. The Gate HTTP module is a CLU class device, and when connecting it to the system, we do not use the system bus for communication. Instead, it will communicate with other CLU class modules in our system using the Ethernet port. When mounting the module in the switchboard, we connect it to the same switch router to which we previously connected the CLU module or other gate-type modules. Although the module has bus connections, it does not communicate with the system via the bus. However, you can connect the module between other modules, and through the connectors on it, communication on the bus will be forwarded. The Gate HTTP module connects to other elements in the Grenton system using the internet layer. To connect to the devices that we want to control, we use HTTP protocols. On the other hand, the devices we want to control must have an open API. What is an API? In the simplest and most general terms, API is a set of command rules issued outside by this device, such as a protocol or rather a communication interface. The module can be powered from the TF bus side, but it also has connectors dedicated to power supply, which means we can connect it directly to the power supply. And I think that this connection method will be definitely more optimal. Before we move on to the configuration, I will tell you about the virtual objects which are in the Gate HTTP module. There you can find HTTP listener and HTTP request, and also the timer object, which you already know from the previous videos. If we would like to use the Grenton system to control a multimedia loudspeaker, specifically using the Gate HTTP module, we will use an HTTP request type virtual object. This object will be used to send standard POST or GET queries in JSON or XML format. On the other hand, if we want an external device or an external server to be able to download some values from our system, for example, information about the read temperature, we will use an HTTPS listener type virtual object because in our system, you will not find such a thing as a ready API. You will create this API yourselves within the configuration. The system is open enough to allow you to access practically any value contained in it, and you will create the query structure yourself. Let's move on to the configuration. I would like to show you how, using the Gate HTTP module, we can download information from websites, and we will do it using the Open Weather service as an example. Open Weather is a website that has an open API, and therefore allows us to download the data that it presents. Let's go to the web page. To download data from the site, you have to create an account, and then here you can see an example link. Then you construct a query about the value we are interested in the form of such a link. I already prepared this link a little earlier. So now you can see what it looks like. Now, after calling the link with the query we are interested in, you will see the answer. The answer may not be very clear at first glance, so in the next step, we can copy it and transfer it to the JSON parser. Because I know that with the Open Weather server, queries and responses will be in the JSON format. Okay, but if we already have a response from the server, in the next step, we go to the Object Manager software. We'll collapse the view here so we can only see the gate HTTP module. As you can see, the gate HTTP module is a CLU class object. So, as I said earlier, we start by creating a new virtual object. It will be HTTP request. Let's call it open underscore weather. And we'll go straight to the embedded features. The host in our link will be the first part, meaning our server address. We copy it and paste it into the initial value for this feature. Next, we need to complete the query path. The query path is this part from our link, so we do the same thing. We also copy and paste for the initial value of this feature. We still need to specify query parameters. Query parameters, in my case, will be the part preceded by the Q sign. As before, copy and paste it to the initial value of this feature. Since we want to download data from the server, in the next step, we will use the get method. We also need to specify the query and response type. We know that OpenWeather returns them in JSON format, so we will set this exact value for both of these features. Okay, our request virtual object is already set up, so next we create a script. We go to text editing, and in our script we will create a local variable. Let's call it response, to which we will add information downloaded from the OpenWeather server. We enter here the path to our gate HTTP, and then select the response underscore body method from the list. After executing this instruction, the response you saw in the browser earlier will be written to our local variable, which we call resp. Now, we would like to obtain a value for temperature from this response. In the next step, we will create a temperature user feature on our gate HTTP module. I already created it earlier. In the next step of our instruction, to this temperature feature, we'll select it from the list. Here we will substitute the value of this parameter from the entire received response. How to construct it? You can see by the result of our parser. We are interested in the temperature, which is the main parameter. So we go back to our script and enter resp, which is the response. Main and temp. We have to run the script prepared in this way when we receive a response from our server. So we reopen our virtual object, go to events, and assign our script to the onResponse event. We send the configuration, reopen our object. Now we can use the sendRequest method. So at this point, our gate HTTP is sending a request to the OpenWeather server. We'll check right away. In the embedded features, we see status code 200, which means that we have received a response from the server. We can also go to our temperature user feature, and as you can see, we have the current temperature for Krakow. In the next step, we can display this temperature, for example, in our mobile application, on the smart panel display, or use it when creating logic, so the system knows how to react when the forecast temperature for today is lower, higher, or when we expect rain. Similarly, you can create a logic that will allow you to download different values from different web servers or control IoT devices that are in your homes. For popular or frequently used devices, we add ready-made virtual objects that significantly improve the gate HTTP module configuration process speed. An interesting example are Sonos speakers. Look how we can configure them. As before, we start the configuration by adding a new virtual object. We choose a Sonos object. Let's call it Sonos_salon. We move to the embedded features, where here we need to enter the correct address of our speaker. My speaker has an address ending with 100. And that's all. Now we can open our virtual object, and in the embedded features, you can see what state our speaker is currently in, what song it will play. And we can control it right away. You can use the same features, methods, and their events to control the speaker, for example, from Grenton Smart Panels or our mobile application. Thank you for your attention and join us for the next parts of the Grenton Academy.